رب ارحم ضعف بدني ورقة جلدي ودقة عظمي، يا من بدأ خلقي وذكري وتربيتي وبري وتغذيتي، هبني لابتداء كرمك وسالفي بالركاب، يا إلهي وسيدي وربي، أتراك معذبي بنارك بعد توحيدك وبعد ما انطوى عليه قلبي من معرفتك ولهج به لساني من ذكرك واعتقده ضميري من حبك، بعد صدق اعترافي ودعائي خاضعا لربوبيتك، هيهات أن تكرم من أن تضيع من ربيته، أو تبعد من أدنيته، أو تشرد من آويته، تسلم إلى البلاء من كفيته أو رحمته. وليت شعري يا سيدي وإلهي ومولاي أتسلط النار على وجوه خرت لعظمتك ساجدة، وعلى ألسن نطقت بتوحيدك صادقة وبشكرك مادحة، وعلى قلوب اعترفت بإلهيتك محققة، وعلى رحوت من العلم صارت خاشعة، وعلى جوارح سعات إلى أوطان تعبدك وأشارت بغيرك مذنة، ما هكذا الظن بك، ولا أخبرنا بفضلك عنك يا كريم يا رب، وأنت تعلم ضعفي عن قليل من بلاء الدنيا وعقوباتها وما يجري فيها من المكاره على أهلها، على أن ذلك بلاء ومكروه، قليل مكثوه، يسير بقاؤه، قصير مدته، فكيف احتمالي لبلاء الآخرة وجليل وقوع المكاره فيها، وهو بلاء تطول مدته ويدوم مقامه ولا يخفف عن أهله، لأنه لا يكون إلا عن غضبك وانتقامك وسخطك، وهذا ما لا تقوم له السماوات والأرض يا سيدي، فكيف بي وأنا عبدك الضعيف الذليل الحقير المسكين المستكين، يا إلهي وربي وسيدي ومولاي، لأي الأمور إليك أشكو، ولما منها أضج وأبكي، لأليم العذاب وشدته، أم لطول البلاء ومدته، فلئن صيرتني للعقوبات مع أعدائك وجمعت بيني وبين أهل بلائك وفرقت بيني وبين أحبائك وأوليائك، فهبني يا إلهي وسيدي ومولاي وربي، صبرت على عذابك فكيف أصبر على فراقك، وهبني صبرت على حر نارك فكيف أصبر عن النظر إلى كرامتك، أم كيف أسكن في النار ورجائي عفوك، فبعزتك يا سيدي ومولاي أقسم صادقا، لئن تركتني ناطقا لأضجن إليك بين أهلها ضجيج الآملين، ولأصرخن إليك صراخ المستصرخين، ولأبكين عليك بكاء الفاقدين، ولأنادينك أين كنت يا ولي المؤمنين، يا غاية آمال العارفين، يا غياث المستغيثين، يا غياث المستغيثين، يا حبيب قلوب الصادقين، ويا إله العالمين. أفتراك سبحانك يا إلهي وبحمدك تسمع فيها صوت عبد مسلم سجن فيها بمخالفته وذاق طعم عذابها بمعصيته، وحبس بين أطباقها بجرمه وجريرته، وهو يضج إليك ضجيج مؤمل لرحمتك، ويناديك بلسان أهل توحيدك، ويتوسل إليك بربوبيتك. يا مولاي، فكيف يبقى في العذاب وهو يرجو ما سلف من حلمك؟ أم كيف تؤلمه النار وهو يأمل فضلك ورحمتك؟ أم كيف يحرقه لهيبها وأنت تسمع صوته وترى مكانه؟ أم كيف يشتمل عليه زفيرها وأنت تعلم ضعفه؟ أم كيف يتقلقل بين أطباقها وأنت تعلم صدقه؟ أم كيف تزجره زبانيتها وهو يناديك يا رباه؟ أم كيف يرجو فضلك في عتقه منها فتتركه فيها؟ هيهات، ما ذلك الظن بك، ولا المعروف من فضلك، ولا مشبه لما عاملت به الموحدين من برك وإحسانك. فباليقين أقطع لولا ما حكمت به من تعذيب جاحديك، وقضيت به من إخلاد معانديك، لجعلت النار كلها بردا وسلاما، وما لأحد فيها مقرا ولا مقاما. لكنك تقدست أسماؤك، أقسمت أن تملأها من الكافرين، من الجنة والناس أجمعين، وأن تخلد فيها المعاندين. وأنت جل ثناؤك قلت مبتدئا، وتطولت بالإنعام متكرما، أفمن كان مؤمنا كمن كان فاسقا لا يستوون؟ إلهي وسيدي، فأسألك بالقدرة التي قدرتها، وبالقضية التي حتمتها وحكمتها وغلبت من عليه أجريتها، أن تهب لي في هذه الليلة وفي هذه الساعة كل جرم أجرمته، وكل ذنب أذنبته، وكل قبيح أسررته، وكل جهل عملته، كتمته أو أعلنته، أخفيته أو أظهرته، وكل سيئة أمرت بإثباتها الكرام الكاتبين الذين وكلتهم بحفظ ما يكون مني، وجعلتهم شهودا علي مع جوارحي، وكنت أنت الرقيب علي من ورائهم والشاهد لما خفي عنهم، وبرحمتك أخفيته، وبفضلك سترته، وأن توفر حظي من كل خير تنزله، أو إحسان تفضلوه، أو بر تنشروه، أو رزق تبسطوه، أو ذنب تغفروه، أو خطأ تستروه. يا ربي يا ربي يا رب، يا ربي يا ربي يا ربي، يا إلهي وسيدي ومولاي ومالك رقي، يا من بيده ناصيتي، يا عليما بضري ومسكنتي، يا خبيرا بفقري وفاقتي، يا ربي يا ربي يا رب،
يا ربي يا ربي يا رب، يا ربي يا ربي يا رب.
أسألك بحقك وقدسك وأعظم صفاتك وأسمائك أن تجعل أوقاتي من الليل والنهار بذكرك معمورا، وبخدمتك موصولا، وأعمالي عندك مقبولا، حتى تكون أعمالي وأورادي كلها وردا واحدا، وحالي في خدمتك سرمدا. يا سيدي يا من عليه معولي، يا من إليه شكوت أحوالي، يا ربي يا ربي يا رب،
يا ربي يا ربي يا رب.
قوي على خدمتك جوارحي، واشدد على العزيمة جوانحي، وهب لي الجد في خشيتك، والدوام في الاتصال بخدمتك، حتى أسرح إليك في ميادين السابقين، وأسرع إليك في البارزين، وأشتاق إلى قربك في المشتاقين، ودنوى منك دنوى المخلصين، وأخافك مخافة الموقنين، وأجتمع في جوارك مع المؤمنين. اللهم ومن أراد المسلمين بسوء فارد، ومن كادهم فكد. اللهم ومن أرادني بسوء فارد، ومن كادني فكد. واجعلني من أحسن عبيدك نصيبا عندك، وأقربهم منزلة منك، وأخصهم زلفة لديك، فإنه لا ينال ذلك إلا بفضلك. وجد لي بجودك، واعطف علي بمجدك، واحفظني برحمتك، واجعل لساني بذكرك لهجا، وقلبي بحبك متيما، ومن علي بحسن إجابتك، وأقلني عثرتي، واغفر زلتي، فإنك قضيت على عبادك بعبادتك، وأمرتهم بدعائك، وضمنت لهم الإجابة، فإليك يا ربي نصبت وجهي، وإليك يا ربي مددت يدي، فبعزتك استجب لي دعائي. يملك إلا الدعاء، فإنك فعال لما تشاء. يا من اسمه دواء وذكره شفاء وطاعته غنى، ارحم من رأس ماله الرجاء وسلاحه البكاء. يا سابغ النعم، يا دافع النقام، يا نور المستوحشين في الظلام، يا عالما لا يعلم، صل على محمد وآل محمد، وافعل بنا ما أنت أهله. وصلى الله على رسوله والأئمة الميامين من آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. أزول سيدي مولاي عبد الله صلاته على نفسي ونيابة عن والدي ووالدي والدي وكل من قضى الدعاء زياره قربة الله تعالى. السلام عليك يا وائث آدم صفوة الله، السلام عليك يا وائث نوح نبي الله، السلام عليك يا وائث إبراهيم خليل الله، السلام عليك يا وائث موسى كليم الله، السلام عليك يا وائث عيسى روح الله، السلام عليك يا وائث محمد حبيب الله، السلام عليك يا وائث أمير المؤمنين علي ولي الله، السلام عليك يا ابن محمد المصطفى، السلام عليك يا ابن علي المرتضى، السلام عليك يا ابن فاطمة الزهراء، السلام عليك يا ابن خديجة الكبرى، السلام عليك يا ثأر الله وابن ثاره والوتر الموتور. أشهد أنك قد أقمت الصلاة وآتيت الزكاة وأمرت بالمعروف ونهيت عن المنكر وأطعت الله ورسوله حتى أتاك اليقين. فلعن الله أمة قتلتك، ولعن الله أمة ظلمتك، ولعن الله أمة سمعت بذلك فرضيت به. يا مولاي يا أبا عبد الله، أشهد أنك كنت نورا في الأصلاب الشامخة والأرحام المطهرة، لم تنجسك الجاهلية بأنجاسها ولم تلبسك من مدلهمات ثيابها، وأشهد أنك من دعائم الدين وأركان المؤمنين، وأشهد أنك الإمام البر التقي الرضي الزكي الهادي المهدي، وأشهد أن الأئمة من ولدك كلمة التقوى وأعلام الهدى والعروة الوثقى والحجة على أهل الدنيا. وأشهد الله وملائكته وأنبياءه ورسله أني بكم مؤمن وبإيابكم موقن، بشرائع ديني وخواتيم عملي، وقلبي لقلبكم سلم، وأمري لأمركم متبع. صلوات الله عليكم وعلى أرواحكم وعلى أجسادكم وعلى أجسامكم وعلى شاهدكم وعلى غائبكم وعلى ظاهركم وعلى باطنكم. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك. عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت، وبقي الليل والنهار، ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين الذين بذلوا مهجهم دون الحسين. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى أخيك أبا الفضل العباس وعلى أختك الحوراء زينب. اللهم وصل على أئمة المسلمين علي بن الحسين زين العابدين ومحمد بن علي الباقر وجعفر بن محمد الصادق وموسى بن جعفر الكاظم وعلي بن موسى الرضا ومحمد بن علي الجواد وعلي بن محمد الهادي والحسن بن علي العسكري والخلف الهادي المهدي. حججك على عبادك وأمنائك في بلادك صلاة كبيرة دائمة تامة. اللهم هؤلاء أئمتي بهم أتولى ومن أعدائهم أتبرأ. اللهم ارزقني في الدنيا زيارتهم وفي الآخرة شفاعتهم. اللهم وصل على ولي أمرك القائم المؤمل والعدل المنتظر وحفه بملائكتك المقربين وأيده بروح القدس يا رب العالمين. اللهم كن لوليك الحجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصل اللهم على خير خلقك محمد وآله الطاهرين.
سهل لكم امورك ان شاء الله. أبو علي فرنتان بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على أشرف الخلق والأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا وحبيب قلوبنا محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Dear brothers and sisters, inshallah tonight, as some of the members requested about knowing more about the stories of the prophets or the prophets' stories. So, inshallah, I'm going to start from tonight talking about the prophets starting from Adam, alayhi salam, and as you know that the best stories, it is the stories of the Quran. And this is what we need to rely on. We may have some books of Qusasul Anbiya. We may have some stories of some books about Qusasul Anbiya. It should be like the first source of these stories of the prophets must be from Quran, not from the narrations. If it is from the narrations, because we know some of the ulama, they do not investigate these narrations, and they will try to, like, you know, combine all the narrations talking about one prophet or one messenger, and it may have some contradictions. Anyhow, so as far as we are going to do, inshallah, we are going to rely on tafsir of Quran and the authentic tafsir by Sayyid Tabatabai, Sheikh Nasser Makarim Shirazi, and others. So, the first story is going to be about the story of Adam alayhi salam. Basically, we are going to talk about the three, subjects. There's Adam and the angels, Adam wal Malaika, Adam in the heaven, and little bit focus on what happened with the shaytan, and then Adam on the earth. About what? Of course, she is not a prophet, but she is included, of course, here. So this is the ayah that you need to focus on when we read about Adam alayhi salam. It starts with وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خليفة قالوا أتجعل فيها من يفسد فيها ويسفك الدماء ونحن نسبح بحمدك ونقدس لك قال إني أعلم ما لا تعلمون. سورة البقرة آية number 30. When your Lord said to the angels, I am placing a successor on the earth, they said, will you place in it someone who will cause corruption in it and shed blood while we declare your praises and sanctify you. He said, I know what you do not know. Then the next ayah, وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا ثُمَّ عَرَضَهُمْ عَلَى الْمَلَائِكَةِ فَقَالَ أَنْبِئُونِ بِأَسْمَائِ هَؤُلَاءِ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. And he taught Adam the names, all of them. Then he presented them to the angels and said, tell me the names of these, if you are sincere. قَالُوا سُبْحَانَكَ لَنَا لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا إِلَّا مَا عَلَّمْتَنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ. They said, the glory be to you, we have no knowledge except what you have taught us. It is you who are the knowledgeable, the wise. And then, in this ayah, قَالَ يَا آدَمُ أَنْبِئْهُمْ بِأَسْمَائِهِمْ فلما أنبأهم بأسمائهم قال ألم أقل لكم إني أعلم غيب السماوات والأرض وأعلم ما تبدون وما كنتم تكتمون. So you see these four ayahs from ayah number 30 in Surah Al-Baqarah till this one. It is a kind of what? It is a dialogue, all right, or discussion between Allah and His angels. Let's just stop for 1 minute about this. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has to have this kind of dialogue, this kind of conversation with His angels? Why He don't tell them, I decided to do this and you didn't to do that, and He didn't, why He opened the door for conversation? Why? So this is a good answer, so we can learn. What else? I heard one of the ulama, he was saying, it is a kind of like Allah is teaching us to be to have a kind of democratic way in our life that give others the right to express their opinion, and maybe they will differ from you, and this is a lesson that we can learn from Quran. All right. Maybe this, maybe that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to show us through this debate is something, or like dialogue. I prefer to use the dialogue, okay? It is hiwar in Arabic, that we can have some discussion, okay? Better than debate. Debate is always, I just want to improve my point is right, okay? In any way, maybe, okay? But this is not what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. From hiwar, from dialogue, we need to find the truth. And this is very important. He said, I am placing a successor on the earth. So from the beginning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a plan for us. through our father Adam. يعني الله من خلقنا سوي لنا مخطط خطة. وين الله خالقنا؟ الله سبحانه وتعالى planned to create us where? In heaven or on the earth? Here, on the earth. إني جاعلٌ. I'm placing on the earth a successor, okay? So from the beginning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to have Adam and Eve, as Abu Ali, he asked about her, on the earth. So the beginning of mankind on the earth. So put this in your mind. Adam as a human is Allah's successor. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us this kind of duty. So we are going to be his successors on the earth. Why? Are we capable to do that? Are we capable to make this heaven? Yes. But humans, the corrupt ones, the greedy ones, we just want to gain more than others. That's why we have seen corruption. We have seen, like, you know, wars. And every day we have going with this cycle. This successor possesses outstanding skills and capabilities. Yes, with our knowledge as humans, either to use it to help each other or to kill each other, to cure any kind of disease or to create like diseases and kill others, right? So we have a lot of capabilities and different kind of skills. Let's go to the next ayah. وَإِذْ قَالَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ أَبَى وَاسْتَكْبَرَ وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ. And we said to the angels, bow down to Adam. They bowed down except for Satan, for Iblis. He refused, was arrogant, and was one of the disbelievers. Alright, some notes about this ayah. Satan was one of the jinn. He wasn't one of the angels. Then he disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No, jinn, similar to us in many ways. Except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them out of fire and he created us out of clay. But the same desire, the same kind of evilness or goodness in our souls and so on and so forth. But Satan, he was a good servant to Allah, but he had one problem that destroyed all his record or history. His arrogance hindered him from obeying Allah. Maybe there is one thing that we have is going to make us make a fatal mistake or to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Arrogance. One of the worst things that if we have it as a human also is going to cause us a lot of problems. Satan openly expressed his animosity towards humans. And other verses, of course, that I'm going to attempt them and try to deviate them. Okay? By what? Just temptations, just whispering, no more than that. Allah is fair. Allah is not going to make anyone to control you. Nor jinn, neither like, you know, neither jinn nor other like things. So we have our free will to do or not to do. To respond to some temptations, alright, or not. To obey or disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The last thing here, it is important for us to remain vigilant. Again, is the temptations of shaitan. Shaitan will never come to you and ask you to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will try to tell you, for example, like, you can go with your friends, it's okay. See, you need to see what they are doing. All right, they are asking you to, like, you know, get out and have some fun. And you know they are corrupt friends. So shaitan always is whispering to you. Just do it. try to check, visit this website. Try to do this and that. Yes. Question? Yes. At the beginning, it is not amana makrullah. It is about, like, you know, let's go back to that first ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the angels to bow down to make sujood. And he was included. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored him at the beginning and made him among the angels. So he elevated his status. And when he, as a jinn, became among the angels, means that he is a good servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah wanted to show us that even though he reached this level, still he has something is going to make him disobey Allah or to disobey him. It is arrogance. So Allah wanted to show us that be careful. No. He was sincere. In other, like, you know, verses in Quran, he insisted, I'm better than him. Why you are asking me to, like, you know, bow down to him? You created him from clay and you created me from fire, and fire is better than clay. Yes, he cannot challenge, but he said, I'm going to do this. Yes, he failed. That's right. Now, Adam wal Jannah. This is a big discussion. How come Adam, he is in the heaven and he caused us, as we are his sons, to, like, you know, to be kicked out of heaven. Yes. And Still now, Christians and maybe the Jews, they will say, this is because we are here on the earth because of our father's sin. And it is because of the temptation of his wife, Eve. So women, listen to this. Women, they are so the source of evil. And in the Torah, the Old Testament, they said, women, like, you know, the rib, this curve, which means not straight, which means that they are causing a lot of problems. That's why they needed men to correct them. And of course, this is not what the Quran is saying. We totally disagree with this statement. And all right, and that I don't want to go on this. وَقُلْنَا يَا آدَمُ اسْكُنْ أَنْتَ وَزَوْجُكَ الْجَنَّةِ. So, is it really a Jannah? We said, O Adam, inhabit the garden. So was that a true heaven, like the heaven that we are going to go after death? Or is it something different? Yes, what do you think? Okay, so it is not the real heaven, yes. Where is that? Do we know where? نجف صحراء يا معوذ Okay, so we don't know. It is a garden where Allah knows. And this is not very important to us. But the most important thing to us, that was not the actual heaven that Allah promised us to go after death if we are doing good, right? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed him and his wife Eve in the heaven. And he told them, you can enjoy eating, drinking, walking, playing, having fun. except one tree, do not approach it, do not eat from it. Allah didn't tell us about that tree. Do you know what was the tree that they ate from it? They said it is apple. Others said it is wheat tree or sabarjal, or, you know, it must be like a very good tree. All right? Now we need to go to narrations. And with the narrations, one of the, you know, sheikhs, he says, it seems that he likes the Indian mango a lot. He said, really, apple or this or that? Man, you know, the Indian mango is the best. Maybe the temptation with like a mango tree, all right? It doesn't matter which tree. So it was a very clear prohibition, or like, you know, do not approach, do not eat from that tree. What happened? So the question is, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him in that Jannah while he, Allah, said, I created him to be on earth? So these are some of the answers by our ulama. Typically, children find the necessary care and protection within their family environment, right? We were born as babies, and we have been raised by them. So we learn about this life slowly, slowly, right? And Adam alayhi salam, he is not. Allah created him as like an old man or like a young man. So did he have any experience before? Zero experience, right? Just Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught him some names, and then he said these names to the angels. Adam did not have the privilege of growing up in a nurturing family environment. Therefore, he required what? Something special, right? When you are going to start a new job, are you going to sit in the office from the first day? When you are going to go to, like, you know, the university, are you going to attend the classes immediately, or there is an orientation? There is an orientation, right? There is a training session before you go and, you know, start your job, right? Something similar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him in that garden. It's a kind of a training session. It's a kind of, like, you know, a special facility for him and his wife to get used to the true earth that he is going to go to. Enabling him to fulfill his role as the caretaker of the earth. Yes. When he is going to come down to earth, there are responsibilities. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him one responsibility. Eat, drink, except one tree. So one thing, okay? But when he comes down to earth, he's supposed to do a lot of stuff, right? A lot of responsibilities. So he needs to be trained. Three, the Holy Quran describes paradise as an exceptional nursery for the first human being. All right? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about this Jannah. Iskun anta wa zawjukal Jannah. So he called that place as Jannah. Jannah, one of the meaning of Jannah, it's not paradise. It's not heaven. It's a garden. Okay, maybe a big orchard. Where? In Najaf, as Abu Ali is saying. Sahil al-Biqa, yes. All right. Allah said, but do not approach this tree, lest you become wrongdoers. It is something that he must not do. It is a prohibited thing to him, right? That serve as an instruction. So now this order, do not eat from that tree. We have two kind of commands or prohibitions. Like, for example, I say, the doctor is telling you, you know what, you need to take this medicine and try not to eat rice. Try not to eat, like, you know, bread. Is that kind of, like, you know, don't eat? Are you supposed to do it 100% or you need to, like, you know, cut down? Many ulama, they said, it is this kind of an order to instruct him. It is not a mandatory restriction. It is not an, like, you know, compulsory restriction. If you are going to get out of, you know, the surgery, many times for 1-2 hours, you cannot even drink water, right? It's prohibited for you. Why? It's going to maybe hurt you. So something is prohibited, but something here is not. So we say in Arabic, there are two kind of commands. They call it al-amr al-mawlawi, like salli. Okay? وَلَا تَقْتُلُ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ. Do not kill the innocent soul. These are what? Orders. Mandatory orders. You have to obey it. And we have amr irshadi, like, you know, like an advice, like the doctor advice. Okay? So here it is, like the doctor advice. وَلَا تَقْرَبَ هَذِهِ الشَّجَرَةِ. Do not come to this tree. It is like this. And the consequences, if he is going to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with that, it's not going to go to hell. There's a big difference. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, okay, do not cause corruption, and I did, so I deserve, maybe I deserve to go to hell. If I disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I am openly a wrongdoer, okay, so more likely I'm going to go to hell. Why? Because these are the consequences of my actions. But the consequence of what Adam alayhi salam did is not to go to hell. It is to get out of that garden. And then he got the lesson that Allah wanted him to learn. Yes. Yeah. Like, you know, مرة أنت تظلم نفسك بأنه ما تعمل عمل خير وتحصل ثواب ومرة بمعصية الله. One time you are going to be, like, you know, wrongdoer to yourself. Like, you are not going to pray extra prayers. You are going to miss dua kumail, for example. Alright, you are wasting your time. And sometimes, no, you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So both are dhulum to myself. Wasting my time is a kind of dhulum. We just read, you know, in dua kumail that always make me what? Close to you. Right? And every time and everything that I am doing. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in other verses, وَعَصَى آدَمُ رَبَّهُ فَغَوَى. Obviously, he disobeys his Lord. And he was one of the wrongdoers. Yes. But it is not a sin deserves to go to hell. No. Again, put this in your mind. Allah created him to be on the earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him in that garden, orchard, Jannah, for a while, for a training session. How long? It depends. Until he made a mistake, and now he deserves to go to the earth. That's it. Done. Now, some will argue about, you know, is it against Usma, infallibility? Yes. infallibility. Is it against that? If this is going to contradict Usma? That's another question. Now you just answered one of my questions. If he doesn't have any responsibility, if he was just in the training session or special nurturing, yes, and then why he's supposed to be masoom? He doesn't have any responsibility, right? So, even though if we said that he was masoom, this kind of disobedience, it doesn't mean that he committed a sin. So it is not going to contradict infallibility. Yes, that's right. Okay. فَأَزَلَّهُمَا So there is a mistake here. فَأَزَلَّهُمَا الشَّيْطَانُ عَنْهَا فَأَخْرَجَهُمَا مِمَّا كَانَ فِيهِ وَقُلْنَا اهْبِطُوا بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٌّ So Satan caused them to slip from it. To slip from it, okay? To get out of it. And caused them to depart the state they were in. We said, go down, some of you enemies of one another. Who are they, those enemies? And you will have residence on earth and enjoyment for a while. Now, Adam and Eve lacked any prior exposure to deception, lying, and so in this case, like, you know, they don't have any experience with the shaitan. So that's why he was successful to convince them in other verses that we read that he came to them as a good person and he swore by God. I swear by God, if you eat from this tree, you are going to be among Khalidin, immortal. Say it. Yes, they trusted him because they don't have any experience. Someone is going to deceive them, to lie to them. Their interaction were characterized by what? They are honest people, right? By honesty, simplicity in confronting these kind of situations. And this is not like, you know, a sin, but still disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or command, it was a problem for them. Hence, they failed to consider the possibility of deceit. They didn't have in their mind that a person like this, he swears by God that he is deceiving them. Satan is driven by hatred. Why Satan is doing this? Because yes, he was kicked out from the angels, like, you know, congregation, and he hated this person, Adam, and his sons. So he hates us. Yes. Between God. Yes. Yes. He has no excuse. I just want to analyze the situation. I'm not giving him an excuse. Okay. You know what? Hajj. You know, Ibrahim alayhi salam, he got the lesson. That's why he stoned the shaitan. But Adam, I'm not, you know, justifying what he is saying. I'm analyzing this character, okay, through what the ulama said. He was a simple person. Like, in other words, he was a naive person. And he was, yeah, he was naive, yeah. No. The most, you know, there is no proof that he was a prophet in heaven. Yes. He doesn't have any experience. No. It doesn't sound a bad action when he eats from that, you know? Like, he is just eating from a tree and he is going to be like eternal. That's it. And the person who came to him, as he is one of the sincere advisors to him and to her, both of them. Yes. No. Both. He convinced them, not her. The narrative of she convinced him, like Satan convinced Eve, and she convinced Adam, is wrong. He came to them, he swore to them, and he convinced them. وَقَاسَمَهُمَا, yes, أَنِّي لَكُم مِنَ النَّاصِحِينَ. Yes. So, yes. Yeah, that's right. Not game, Hajj. This part of the plan, yes. Yes, Hajj. Can we listen to Hajj Ali, please? Can you listen? Yes. There's a test, and he came as a human. He came as, like, you know, an advisor, true advisor. Yes. Right away, maybe after 2 days, 3 days, we don't know. How many days? Yes. I'm not going to go to this kind of, like, discussion. Not really. Oh. Yes. All right. So we are going to be done. Just have some patience with me. All right. فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ إِنَّهُ هُوَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught Adam to, like, you know, to repent. All right, to say sorry. Please forgive me. All right? And he taught him certain words to say it. Then fataba alayhi, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his repentance. Innahu wa tawwab ar-rahim. Now, the act of seeking forgiveness and mercy may arise from a sense of what? Someone, why we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness? Because we have done something wrong. So this something which is wrong, either like we deserve to go to hell, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to hate us, or we are not going to gain like some hasanat or rewards, right? So all of that will be in this category. God Almighty did not allow Satan to enjoy the benefits of his victory by teaching Adam to ask for forgiveness, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his repentance. Instead, God revealed to Adam the most effective way to rectify his mistake, his tawbah. So from that we can learn, if I make a mistake, if I disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then I need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness. Yes. Yes, we have some narrations. I told you, these are stories of Quran. These are the stories of the prophets from Quran, okay? Next time, so I want to focus on the main issues, all right? So the main issues are very important to us. To get all the, like, you know, extra things, maybe they are incorrect. Let's get something from these stories. And I know that some of the stories, we don't know about the prophets. We need to learn some lessons. Yes, when Adam alayhi salam came to earth, he became a prophet, and he was infallible. And of course, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to take care of his family and guide them, all right? So it is the actual, let's say, work. It is the actual action on earth. It is not in that garden. So I will go with this opinion that he was not infallible. He was not ma'soom over there. Not necessarily over there, it is up. Maybe it is on the earth. Okay, Najaf, yes. Or Sahil Biqa. All right, any more questions from the sister's side, lady's side? Men always asking. What? Inshallah, when you go to heaven, ask Allah. Yes, yes. According to this narration by Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, is there any human before our father Adam? The answer is yes. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam said, before your father Adam, before your Adam, there were more thousands of nations maybe before us. Do you know how long it is from Adam to today? No, not millions. Yeah, the earth, like with millions, it is the age of the earth. But, you know, with our, like, you know, generations, maybe from 7,000 to 10,000, yes. Yes. Make them what? Who? Yes, I think this is the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to, like, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. لِيَعْبُدُونَ, it means to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the best way. And some of them, they say, to have knowledge, to know, to have knowledge. And when you have knowledge, you can act upon your knowledge. When you know there is a creator, then you are going to try to please your creator, right? And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted us as his successors on the earth to make this earth like heaven. Okay? This is the ultimate goal for the creation. Why we believe in Imam Mahdi ajala ta'ala faraja to come and to spread justice, to make it like heaven. We don't know. Maybe they are humans. Maybe Allah created them with something else. But they are. At this point, Could be. Yeah. Hajj. There are things which is not denied by the Quran, right? So the science is saying something, and the Quran didn't say no. But not necessarily we will say yes, because still, maybe these are not facts. It is still scientific, like, you know, theories. Yeah. But are they... Yes, are they on this earth only? No, maybe on this earth and maybe on other planets. We don't know. Yes, that's right.